Welcome to Astrology Experts YouTube channel. In this video, let's talk about relationship compatibility in numerology. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do so, because we have so much content for you guys. If you love content about numerology, zodiac signs, angel number, astrology, and stuff like that, please give this video a like as well, because it would really help us with the algorithm. Okay, so now that's out of the way, make sure to stick with me till the end as we dive right into the video. So how does relationship analysis work in numerology? Let's show you life path numbers that have the easiest relationship compatibility, or in other words, get along with each other the best. Here are some of the following best matches. For master numbers, atom reduced to a single digit. Detailed descriptions of number combinations and the relationship potential. One relationship combinations. One and one. These are good friends that also compete. Their lives are one of excitement. One and two. There isn't an equal balance of power. One will be in charge and needs to give attention to two. 1 and 3. This is a great match that will enjoy life together. 3s stroke the egos of 1. 1 and 4. 1 finds 4 difficult as they want to control everything. While 1 wants to make things happen now, they can work if they accept each other for who they are. They are opposite at times. 1 and 5. They make a great team as they both like their independence. 1 and 6. This isn't always a great match. 1 is independent and out there, while 6 wants a domesticated relationship. 1 and 7. Although different, they work well. 7s give wise insights. 1 motivate the 7s. 1 and 8. Not always a great match as both are so assertive and demanding. They need to compromise and limit demands. 1 and 9. These two work well as the 9's personality lets the 1s get what they need to do. Done. 2 relationship combinations. 2 and 2. There is a lot of politeness and mutual respect between these two, but they have to be careful of hurting each other's feelings. 2 and 3. 2s calm 3's wild and entertaining personality. A good match. 2 and 4. This is a good pairing as the stable and strong 4s take care of the softer 2s, providing a good home. 2 and 5. The 2 needs security and love all the time, while 5 needs freedom. Not a great match. 2 and 6. This is a great match. The 2s just want love and need to care. And the 6s need a domestic life and family. 2 and 7. This can be a tough match at times, as the 2 wants attention, love, and the 7 needs space. Both soft people, it can work with this in mind. 2 and 8. This match really works well. The 8 gets their ego stroked by the 2 while taking care of the family's financial and stability needs, while the 2s take care of the family's emotional needs. 2 and 9. These two cannot work. 9s have a lot of love to give, but to all humanity. Not just a number 2 who wants constant affection. 3 relationship combinations. 3 and 3. This pairing will have so much fun together. The problem is, when too much fun is being had and practical, everyday tasks are not being attended to, but it can definitely work. 3 and 4. This match is not always easy. 4s need to plan ahead, while 3s live in the spur of the moment. It can only work when compromise is reached and the 3 realizes that 4 gives them the security they need, while 3 allows the 4 to let loose and have some fun. 3 and 5. This is a fun relationship that will include social events and travel. They just need to watch the spending between each other. 3 and 6. The 3's enthusiasm is adored by the 6 who provides stability. It is a good match. 3 and 7. This is not a good match as the 7 needs solitude while the 3 needs to constantly socialize. 3 and 8. This doesn't always work well as the 8 is super ambitious and is only happy when they reach their goals. 3 is all about having fun. 3 and 9. This is a wonderful match where 9 will be the teacher and 3 the student. They both like people and will keep each other entertained. 4 relationship compatibility in numerology. 4 and 4. This equals a very stable relationship. They are both hard workers and are orderly and structured and need to get things done. there will be great understanding between each other. 4 and 5, this is a very challenging relationship. 4s are not comfortable with change, while 5s love it. 4 and 6, this equals a happy family home, a good match. 4 and 7, this is a good match. It will be a very serious relationship. 4 and 8, this is a great match. Both are goal-oriented and work hard to secure a solid future. 4 and 9, these two are very different. The 4 is all about growing steadily towards things, and 9 is about humanitarian efforts. They could be good friends. 5 relationship compatibility. 5 and 5. This is a great pairing. They both understand each other well and give each other the freedom they want. 5 and 6. The 6 just wants to nurture and can be overbearing to the 5, who just wants freedom and space. Not necessarily a great match. 5 and 7. This is a great match, as 7s need solitude and 5s need space to do their own thing. 5 and 8. Not the easiest relationship to begin with, as 8s want to be the boss while 5s just want freedom and not to be dominated. 5 and 9. Somewhat incompatible, but can work through it since both are always on the go. 6 relationship compatibility. 6 and 6. This is a great relationship with a lot of nurturing and care. Family is important here, and there's also a lot of romance between these two. 6 and 7. There may be sexual attraction between these two, but the 7 will ultimately find the 6 too controlling. 6 and 8. This is a great match. You will have a home together that is frequented by family and friends. 6 and 9. This is a beautiful match. 6 really respects 9, who expands 6's views of the world. 7 relationship compatibility and numerology. 7 and 7. This is a lovely pairing, as they truly understand one another. The only problem is that they both love their solitude so much, they need to make time for each other for their relationship to progress. 7 and 8. This isn't a great relationship, and they can end up fighting, as 8s love to dominate and 7 hate authority. 7 and 9. This isn't always the best match. It largely depends on their spiritual beliefs and how they communicate that to one another. 8 relationship combinations. 8 and 8. These two make a formidable pair, ready to conquer the world. 8s are especially good when they join forces in business together. 8 and 9. This isn't a great pair. They both have dreams and ambitions, but 8s are more focused towards material aims, while 9's dreams are more humanitarian. 9 relationship combinations. 9 and 9. This is a great pairing, as they both want to make each other very happy. Both can inspire each other. I've given you a link on the description box below so you can compute your life path numbers. If you ever wonder and are curious to know what your partner or your significant others, thank you so much for watching this video and for the like and subscribe as well. I hope this was helpful to you. I'll see you on the next video.